In this problem, we're given a velocity time graph for a particle moving in one dimension. The vertical axis is labeled in tens of meters per second, the horizontal axis labeled in seconds. And in part A, we're asked to construct a plot of the acceleration as a function of time. And then in part B, we're going to get the average velocity for this particle on the time interval 0 seconds to 5 seconds. So we're exploring both the slope and area relationships for this VT graph. For part A, we have to remember that the acceleration as a function of time is given by the slope of the velocity time graph. And we could approach this just by looking at the velocity time graph and saying, okay, every time we go up by 1 second, we go down by 10 meters per second. So this is negative 10 meters per second vertical change per second, or negative 10 meters per second squared. If you wanted to be more formal about it, we could take any 2 points on this line for the velocity time graph and compute the slope between them. So we could go all the way from the first point to the last, and the acceleration is going to be the change in velocity divided by the change in time. And the final velocity is negative 20 on that interval. The initial was 30, and the amount of time it took was 5 seconds. That's negative 50 over 5, and I get negative 10 meters per second squared once again. Now that acceleration function is a constant, because the slope of the velocity function is a constant. So when we plot it on this acceleration time graph, it's just a constant horizontal line at negative 10 meters per second squared. Now in part B, we're asked for the average velocity on the time interval 0 seconds to 5 seconds. Average velocity means the displacement divided by how long it took. So we need to find the total displacement first. Again, average velocity is the displacement delta x divided by the time it takes delta t. And the displacement of this particle is given by the signed area bounded by the velocity curve. So we visualize the signed area real quick. Okay, so there's the area bounded between this velocity function and the t-axis. Both of these are triangles, so we can use geometry formulas to get the area contributions. And I have to remember that above the t-axis, the area counts as positive. I'm going to call this A1. That's the displacement for the first part of the motion. And the area here is 1/2 base times height, so I have 1/2. And then the base is 3 seconds, and the height is 30 meters per second. Notice that the units work out for us. I end up with meters for this displacement, and again, it counts as positive. So 3 times 30 is 90, divided by 2, and I get 45. So I get positive 45 meters for the contribution during that part of the motion. For the smaller triangle, that's going to count as negative. And again, I have 1/2 base times height, and the base here is 2 seconds, and the height is a negative 20 meters per second. Just notice that the signs work out there to give me my negative area, and my units, of course, still work out. 2 times -20 is -40, divide by 2, and I get negative 20 meters for that part of the journey. So my total displacement during this 5 second period is 45 meters in the positive direction. For the first part of the journey, that's when the particle was moving in the positive direction. Then at t equals 3 seconds, the velocity becomes 0 and switches to negative. So the particle starts moving in the negative direction, and the total displacement in that direction was 20 meters. And I end up with a net of 25 meters in the positive direction. Plugging in the positive 25 meters and then dividing by how long it took, that was 5 total seconds. I end up with an average velocity of 5 meters per second. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.